Do you want to make punk rock in Ableton Live intro? Let's do this.
There's a power deep inside.
Ableton Live Suite. So big, so nice, so sweet. But it's £500, Jesus Christ! It's 2022, the inflation, the recession. I mean, we just got rid of Boris here in the UK, but the guys in the US are still dealing with Weekends at Bernie's guy, and oh my god, nobody has £500 to spend on a DAW. In 2022, a DAW should not cost more than £100. And a plugin should not cost more than 30. Come on. If a plugin costs more than that, I should put it in a room, sit it down and say, who do you think you are? What you doing for me? What can you do for me? Why do you cost this much? Oh, you know what they're gonna say. They're gonna say, like, you know how much it costs to make a plugin, to develop a DAW? But then maybe if it's that expensive, maybe you should be more responsible with your money, so I can be more responsible with mine. Cause god damn it, we're punk rockers here. We make punk rock on this channel and we're dirty, cheap people. But wait, look at this. There's Live 11 intro, £69. That's under 100. That's what I thought it should be, but no, man. 16 tracks only? 2 send and return tracks? No EQ8? Are you serious, Ableton? No EQ8? Can we make a punk rock song with these limitations? Yes. Yes, we can, and I'll show you how. The first step is to program some MIDI drums, and I have a video about this, link somewhere here and in the description. Go watch it if you want to see me programming drums from scratch, but here, I programmed some drums, and unfortunately, in Ableton Live Intro, there's no good punk drum sound. I'm sorry, you're not gonna find it, but it's okay, because you can download Steven Slade Drums 5.5 free, and you're gonna use this kit here, Hugo. Let's hear how it sounds. First step, some channel EQ with a smiley curve to bring up the thump and the sizzle. Then EQ3, don't be afraid to put one EQ after the other, it's fine. We were put on this ride and we're gonna ride it now, okay? So EQ3 here, putting a little bit of 133 up. That's gonna bring that attack from the kick and the snare that you need in punk rock. Now you made those drums sound nice, so we're gonna destroy it, cause this is punk rock, right? So the first step, make a little audio effect rack here. Make a clean chain here, nothing on it. Then erosion. Erosion gives a sizzle and a noise to the top that I like, it's pretty punky. It's mixed down pretty low. Next step is saturation to make it thicker. And finally, put some reverb in there, just to make it a little bit moist, you know? You don't want people thinking you're a savage, right? These are all the steps we took for the drums. Moving on to bass, stick it raw dog into the high Z input of your interface. Don't really think too much about it, it's bass, it doesn't really deserve much respect, you know? Just stick it in there, record it, and it's gonna sound horrible. So stick some Amplitube 5 free version on it. Look at that, we're using solid state bass preamp here, but they make sure to put all of the other ones with a little lock in there, just to make sure you know what you're missing. Silly boys, I'm never gonna buy this, I'm gonna use the free version forever. Did you see gas prices? Uh-uh, I don't need all these amps, I need this one, and it's fine. It's fine! So put that amp in there, turn up the bass and the highs a little bit to make it sound more punky. You really want that sloppy punk bass sound, don't you? I do, for sure. Next step, hug it with a compressor here, just a slight hug, just to gaslight it a little bit, just so it does its stupid job, this stupid bass, right? So, what am even say. And then after that, channel EQ to put more of that sloppy bass sound up and destroy it with erosion to give that cheap punk studio sound, you know, where everything's shaking and the outlets are not really grounded and there's that sound. Erosion does that for you, and saturator just to make it thicker. This is how our bass went from start to finish. Now plug in your guitar, and there's nothing sadder than the sound of a guitar being played directly into an interface. So here we go, amplitude free again. And there they are, just rubbing in my face all the amps that I can't have. But it's okay, I'm gonna use this dated emulation of a Marshall amp with this generic distortion pedal right here, and I'm gonna make it work. I never had really good pedals and amps in real life anyway, so I'm used to this, it's fine. I don't need to buy it, it's fine. Make another track, record exactly the same thing again, and spread one left and spread one right real good. 50 left, 50 right. But just when they think they're getting really far from each other, they're never gonna see each other again, you group them so you can destroy them together. In the group, you put a little bit of channel EQ to make it thicker. EQ 3 to clean up that horrible amp sim high end a little bit. And now that you made it nice, you guessed it, make it dirty again. So saturated to make it more dirty. And you got rid of the bad highs. You made some new good highs with saturated. So boost the new good highs with a channel EQ. Make a couple of other guitar tracks just to double up your guitars in the heavier parts of your song, so your chorus or your intro. Just a little touch of high-end and heaviness that I'm using this free amp for, Cypress TT15, another free amp. This one, they don't have other ones to rub on your face, so that's a quite nice one. I like it. And these are the guitars from beginning to end. And lastly, the vocals. I used a dynamic mic like this one, but you don't have to get a fancy one like this. You can just stick a sock on an SM57. It's gonna work just the same. So you can do that if you're even poorer than me. Sing it like you actually mean it, like you actually still feel something. So much pressure in the world, so much pain I can't withhold. I just gotta fortify. Then channel EQ again to boost up those highs. This is a dynamic mic in the end, so you need it. So much pressure in the world, so much pain I can't withhold. Compress the stupid peaks that you sing because you're stupid and you can't sing at all, so you need a compressor to control your voice. So fast attack, high ratio, okay? It's gonna be fine. So much pressure in the world, so much pain I can't withhold. A little bit of EQ 3 to bring some life into your stupid vocals. So much pressure in the world, so much pain I can't withhold. More compression because you suck and you need it, so a little bit slower attack this time though. It's fine, it's gonna be fine. It's just, okay, sorry. So much pressure in the world, so much pain I can't withhold. Saturated to make it, you guessed it, thick. So much pressure in the world, so much pain. And now you sound like you have a lisp, so make a little de-esser here with an Ableton Live compressor. So much pressure in the world, so much pain I can't withhold. All you have to do is turn on this little section here that's hidden in this arrow and choose a frequency and a band pass, and you're gonna be fine. You're gonna de-ess yourself. It's all good. Send it to a reverb with a really long pre-delay to give the illusion that's kind of dry, but it's actually really wet. So much pressure in the world, so much pain I can't withhold. Then send it through a delay and automate some delay throws for some ear candy, you know? Gotta fortify. Kids nowadays, they have TikTok attention spans, so you really gotta give them some candy so they can stick around to the end of your track. Record a double as close as you can to the original and put it to the back, just, you know, to give you that 90s sound.
So much pressure in the world, so much pain I can't withhold, I just gotta fortify.
Sing some harmonies and spread them left and right, just to make it sound like you have friends, even though, obviously, you don't.
Ugly thoughts won't go away, borrow loss I have to pay, I just wanna close my eyes.
And finally, this is a punk song, so you need some gang vocals, right? So record some of them far from the mic, and record some of them close to the mic, and spread them around, maybe 50-50, 17-17, you know, it's up to you. Just to make it sound like you have fans, although you don't, and neither do I, so at least that gives you an illusion, which is nice. Also, don't forget to filter out the high end of your gang vocals, just to stick them to the back a little bit. You know, you don't want your fans too close to you. You know, that's disgusting.
Whoa! But there is doubt within my mind.
Now, nobody has time or money for mastering in punk rock, right? So what we're gonna do? We're gonna stick a bunch of things in the master track and hope that it sounds better. First thing is a limiter to make it loud. You know, the loudness war called, and guess what? The loudness won, so make it loud. Around 12 RMS should be fine in Ableton. If the light green is around minus 12 here on this meter, you're good for loudness, I think. Next step, channel EQ with a smiley curve, because what else it does? I don't know, I'm so tired of it by now. But yeah, smiley curve, channel EQ, open up that mix. Now compress it sensibly, just with a slow attack and a fast release and a low ratio, just, you know, to give that little bit of a glue. Then saturate it a little bit. Why not? It's dirty, right? It's punk rock. You gotta be more punk than the other punks. So, saturation. Now compress it aggressively. Really squeeze it out, but mix it really low there. Just so it's a little touch of aggressiveness, right? Just a little touch there in the background. No, nobody's looking at it. Don't worry about it. Woo! And that's it. Let's go from beginning to end on this little chain here and just check how it sounds. You see, incremental little steps to make everything sound a little bit better. Is it mastering? Is it not? I don't know. It's just making it sound better. I hope. I hope you liked this video as well. I know I tried something a little bit different. I hope you liked it. If you did, please press all the buttons around me that help me out there in this world. Subscribe to the channel. You know, do all the things that help me. And if you like this video, please let me know. Or if you want me to go back to being more of a serious teacher, let me know as well in the comments below. And I see you all next time. Thank you and bye. We'll be right back.